Hello students, today we are going to study about linear regression. Linear regression is a popular machine learning technique which is used to predict the outcome of a certain entity based on historical values, and this entity whose value has to be predicted has to be a numeric or continuous variable, which is also known as the target variable. This is a very popular machine learning technique. Machine learning is a technique in which the machine is trained with a set of data, and with the help of these data, the machine generates new rules, like we human beings generate new rules and make decisions with the help of our past experiences. Machine also it helps the machine to predict the outcome or to make a decision on the basis of the past historical data. So instead of, this is a new technique in which we, instead of programming the computer by writing line by line instructions, we are actually helping the computer to take decisions or to predict the outcome or to give some output with the help of previous data, with the help of training it with a lot of data. So this technique and machine and linear regression is a supervised learning. It uses supervised machine learning technique in which we are actually feeding the machine with a target outcome. That is, we are telling the machine what to predict. So let's look at some of the applications. Like we can, for example, we can predict the property price of buildings with the help of the past data, of which the property prices are already given. With the help of that, we can predict the unknown property price of a building if we know the various details of the building. Similarly, we can predict the monthly sales of a certain product. We can find out the score of a student based on his past performances. A popular machine learning technique you might have seen, which will be in the form of self-driving cars, in which the car picks up new signals with the help of sensors, actuators, and learns on its own, and then it will be able to make decisions that where it should stop or where it should change the gear and so on. So depending on machine learning techniques, there are three types of machine learning techniques which we have. One is supervised machine learning algorithm, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. In supervised machine learning, we already feed the machines with the labeled data. That is, for example, if you are feeding the machine with different kinds of images, we are feeding the machine with two types of images. One is the images of dogs and the images of cat, and these images are already labeled. The machine is trained with the labeled data. After that, if you give the machine a unknown image of a cat which is already not present in the database, which is unlabeled, the machine may be able to identify that it's a cat with a certain accuracy. Unsupervised learning is a type of learning in which the data which we are feeding the machine with is completely unlabeled. So machine does not have any labels to the images, that whether it is a cat or dog. But with the help of pattern identification and similarity calculation, the machine is able to make different clusters or the type of different types of batches which are present in the data. We can, customer segmentation is a example of this, in which the different, if you want to give different types of offers to the customers, you can do unsupervised clustering, and the machine can divide or group your customers into different segments, like according to age or income or spending category and so on. So regression is a type of predictive modeling in which we are actually predicting certain types of outcome or certain type of value which we want to predict, and that value has to be a numeric variable. So predictive models are developed using historical data or from purposely collected data. It's not that linear regression is the only predictive modeling or supervised learning technique. We have other models also. So to do a predictive modeling approach, we have to first, if we are talking about a particular domain, like we were talking about, like we want to find out that whether the property price of the building, in which we have to first then study the domain and understand the data, then we apply the business expertise. That is, we understand that what is this domain used for, which columns we need to keep, and then we develop the statistical model, and after that we find the accuracy of the model, and then we implement the model on the test data. So here in supervised learning, we are actually giving the machines with already labeled data. That is, for example, if I want to classify that the person is a credit card defaulter or not, we already have to supply the machine with a set of data which already contains the details of the customers with the label that whether he is already a defaulter or not. And when the machine is trained with this data, we can validate the machine with an unknown data, test the machine with an unknown data, and check that what the machine is predicting, whether it is a defaulter or not. So main techniques which are there in supervised learning are classification and regression. Classification is basically to classify or to group the data into two or multiple classes. In the classification, the output variable or the target variable has to be an object or a class or a string. In regression, we are expecting the output variable as a numeric value, because here we are predicting the scores of a student, the monthly sales volume, then we can talk about the property price of building and so on. So let's consider this diagram. In this diagram, we are doing a supervised learning technique to train the machine with this data, which is the training data. It consists of two columns. One is the GRE score. Another is the chance of admit. So here, this variable, which is the GRE score, here it is known as the independent variable, or it is the predictor. So with the help of predictor, we are able to find out the chance of admission of the students. So based on his GRE score, we are trying to predict that what is his chance of admission in the university. So the chance of admission is in percentage. It is like 0.92, 0.76. So here we are using a single feature variable and a single target variable. And this technique is called simple linear regression. And this data is fed into the machine made a training model. And with the help of this data, once the machine is trained with this model, the machine will be able to predict the test data, which consists of the GRE score, which is not there in the training data. See, 320 and 325 is not there in the training data, it's absent. So we are able to predict an unknown GRE score. And if we pass this into the machine will be able to predict that with a certain accuracy that what is the chance of admission of the students with this particular GRE score. So this is basically supervised learning technique, in which we are feeding the machine with the training data, which consists of a predictor and a target variable. Now if we are using a single predictor, it is called simple linear regression. If we are using multiple predictors, it is called multiple linear regression. And then once the training machine is trained with that model, the machine has the capacity to predict unlabeled samples. So here we are we are saying this regression model uses target values of prediction which are based on set of independent variables. So here we are using a single independent variable because it is a we are talking about a simple linear regression. The concept is used for finding the relationship between variables and forecasting values. We can also call the dependent variables, that is we are talking about the target variables. That is here chance of admit is the target variable. This is also known as output variable or response variable, also and also called dependent variable. So what does linear regression do? Linear regression finds the relationship between two variables. A simple linear regression finds the relationship between the predictor and the response variable with the help of a line. It is as simple as the equation of a simple line, which is y is equal to mx plus c. And it is a linear function which predicts the response value accurately as feature or independent variable. So for example, let us consider two variables here, because we are talking about simple linear regression in which x is the feature vector, that means it consists of set of values, and y is also a vector which consists of the set of target values. So here y is dependent on x, that is x is influencing the value of y. So if this kind of relationship is not there, then we cannot go for linear regression. That is linear regression can only be applied between two variables in which the target variable is dependent on the predictor. If it is not dependent on the predictor, like if the target variable is not influenced by the predictor at all, like for example property price of a building and the age of the person who is staying in that. So this kind of two variables cannot be related. So linear regression cannot be performed on such kind of predictors. Linear regression can be performed with only two variables who have a linear relationship between them. So before starting with the linear regression, we have to draw a scatter plot between the two variables and check that they fall along the line or not. So we have done a scatter plot and we see that there is a linear pattern of increase. Either there will be increase or there will be a decrease. Some kind of linear pattern should be existing, but it should not be like any kind of random relationship. So let's come to the equation of linear regression. Here we are having y equal to mx plus c, which is the same equation which we use for the for making a line. Okay, so y here is the target variable or the response variable. M here is the slope of the line. X here is the predictor. And C here is the intercept. So what is intercept? Intercept is the point of y where the target variable where the value of x is 0. So that is the intercept. It is the expected mean value of y when all x is 0. So when predictor is 0, what is the response value of the response variable? So that is the intercept. So here, when we talk about the general trend of a regression line, in the scatter chart, what kind of lines should we expect? So that is our regression line. If we check the value of a regression line, so either it will be positive or it will be negative or it can be zero. So positive means the target variable is directly proportional to the predictor. That is, if the predictor is increasing, the response variable is also increasing. So a simple example will be like, for example, the property price the property price is directly proportional to the number of rooms present in the house. Okay, so as the number of rooms increases, the property price also increases. That is directly proportional. So in this case, we are talking about this slope of the line, that is M. M is also known as the regression coefficient. So in this case, the regression coefficient, which is signified by beta, is zero, is positive. If there is no change, then beta will be 0. In that case, we cannot perform linear regression. There is another kind of scenario in which when the x is increasing, y is decreasing. For example, we can talk about the crime, percentage of crime of a in the locality and the property price. If the crime in the locality is very high, the property price will decrease. So in this case, it is inversely proportional. So these are the three kinds of scenarios which we have, which we see the trend of a general regression line. Okay, so here you can see three means the, you can see the line is starting from the, this y value is 3 when the x value is 0. So it is 3. Here the value of y is 10 when x is 0. So the intercept is 10. So some of the examples of linear regression can be like, if you want to predict the tip on the basis of total bill, the tip is on the higher the amount of bill, the tip also increases. Then here we can see there is a single predictor and a single response variable, single target variable. So we can perform simple linear regression. When we have multiple predictors and a single response variable, we can perform multiple regression. Or if we want to perform simple regression, we have to take a single predictor from here. Here we are talking about the university admission. Here we have different kinds of scores which are there, in which we had selected the GRE score, and chance of admit is the target variable here. So let's take a case study. For example, a small restaurant owner, here he knows that the tips are directly proportional to the bills of the customer. So he wants to make a prediction about the amount of tip to be expected for any given bill amount. So here are the total bill and the tip. And now we want to find out that how to predict an unknown bill. With the unknown bill, the tip, we want to predict that, and how to make the regression line here. So if we plot this, we get a scatter chart like this, which shows a pretty linear kind of relationship. And then we need to find the appropriate regression line. So according to statistics, the best fit regression line should pass through the mean of x and mean of y, which is also known as the centroid. So we need to find the mean of x and mean of y here, and make a regression line which pass through the centroid. So here you can see the mean of x and mean of y is, mean of x is 74 and mean of y is 10. And we need to pass our regression line through here. So here you can see, and then what we do is, we need to calculate the residuals. What is the residuals? The residuals are the deviations from this line. So if we are passing a line from the centroid, the difference from the actual data points from that line is from the mean of the line is, it is known as the residuals, and that is also known as the error. Okay, so we need to calculate that residuals, and with the help of the residuals we'll be able to calculate the slope of the line. So here you can see we have calculated the residuals. Let me show you on Excel how to do it. So here you can see we have this bill and the tip. And here we are checking the, let's calculate the mean. So here, okay, this is actually, give me a moment. We'll open it in OpenOffice. Okay, so here it is. Now let's calculate the average. And here. Okay, now what I am doing is residual of x, or you can say deviation. Minus mean of x, that is deviation from the mean, because the line is passing through the mean. So here we get the deviation from the mean of x, and we are getting deviation of y. So here, and then we find a product of this deviation. So here, so let's do a product of this deviation, and then we do a square of x deviation. So let's do a sum of this. And then our m is equal to So this is our slope of the line, or it is also known as the regression coefficient here. Okay, and our formula is y equal to mx plus c. So now if I want to find the value of c, or the intercept, c will be y minus mx. So y here is the mean of y, which is 10. So 10 minus here, x is the mean of x. So this is our intercept. So now we will calculate, when we see it using Python, we can see that this is the exact answer which we get. So let's go back to our PPT here. Okay, so here 74 and 10, and here we have calculated the residuals. So this is like our objective is to minimize the residuals. Our objective is to minimize the residuals. So that is we apply ordinary least square regression for doing that, for minimizing the residuals. Now after this, we are doing this. We are multiplying the product and dividing by xi, that is the value of x minus the mean of x whole square. This we have done, and we have calculated the value of, see, you can see this is the same thing which I have calculated in Excel, and we get this answer 0.1462x minus 8203. Now what happens, once we form this equation, any value of x, if you have, which is unknown, which is not there in this bill, for example we are talking about, if the bill amount is 200, then what, then you substitute the value of x here as 200 and get the value of predicted value of y. That is how simple it is. So this is simple linear regression. So then we need to find that how our algorithm is performing. For that we have this, this is one matrix which is known as R square. So what is R square? R square is the difference, is the ratio of the difference between the value of y means the target variable, and the predicted value of y, difference whole square, to the value of y to the mean of y whole square. So why we are doing whole square? Because now we don't want a minus here, minus, and we are doing a summation, so minus and plus will cancel, so we are doing a whole square, and then we are performing a sum, and then we are doing it from, we are subtracting it from 1. The value of R square will differ from 0 to 1. 1 means 100%, that means your accuracy is 100% accuracy, and as the R square's value is closer to 0, the accuracy is decreasing. Multiple linear regression is the also the same, only thing in this here the equation here B0 we are considering it is as the intercept, and we have multiple values of x. Each x is associated with the regression coefficient of its own. So that is how we have this. Apart from that, everything is same. So now let's do let's see a case study here. So here you can see we have imported pandas and we are reading the data, and we are extracting the first 5 records. Then we are selecting only the GRE score and chance of admit column, because here we have multiple columns and we want to do simple linear regression. So chance of admit, here it is the 8th column, and GRE score is the first column because it is starting from 0. And then we are getting the DF1, that is we are just printing that how many records are there, and here we have the data. And now we have to separate X and Y as different vectors. So we are using this iloc function to get the 0. Yeah, so because 0 means here we have a new data set which is DF1. DF1 0 means GRE score. So 0 we are getting only the GRE score in DF1 underscore X. And then we are converting it into numeric column, because it's showing as an object column. In that case, you will not be able to do the linear regression here. And chance of admit, we are putting it as Y vector. And we are doing it as numeric column. Okay, now we are doing it like we have done it in the presentation. So we are calculating the mean of x. So df1 underscore x underscore mean, which is np dot mean, that is np is the numpy, and we are calculating the mean of x, and mean is giving us GRE score mean is 322.6. Okay. Similarly, df1 y underscore mean is giving the mean of y, which is giving us as the chance of admits mean is 0.77. And then we calculate the deviation. This is the deviation which we are calculating, and deviation of y. Then we are calculating the product of deviation. We are doing just like we have done it in Excel. And sum of product of deviation. And then we are calculating the square of deviation of x. Deviation underscore x whole square. And then we are calculating the regression coefficient, which is sum of product deviation divided by sum of square x deviation. and this regression coefficient we are getting as 0.010666. And then we are calculating the intercept, which is giving us -2.6709. And if I have an unknown test data here, 320 and 325, which is our unknown GRD score, and we want to find the predicted value. So now what we are doing, we are putting the value of substituting the value of x in y equal to mx plus c. So here regression coefficient, which we have already calculated, multiplied by test data 0, which is 320, plus intercept also we have already calculated here. Here intercept, and this is the data which we are getting. And then we are implementing linear regression with sklearn library. So this is the predicted value. So this is our chance of admit. So now what we are doing, we are implementing the linear regression with the sklearn library. So we are using import linear regression. This is far more easy because we are just doing a model.1.fit, and this is actually training with the value of x and the value of y. And then we are printing the model's coefficient, which is a linear regression coefficient. You can see this is the same coefficient which we are getting, 0.010666, and printing the intercept. And when we are creating the data set here, and with the help of data set, when we are getting the predicting the chance of admit, it is 74 and 79. Okay, and here R2 score is giving me 92%. R2 score is the R square, which we are. This R square shows me that how accurate is your model, so that it can be implemented. If your model is 60% accurate, you need to improve it and choose a different combination of feature variables so that you can get a better R square. Let me show you the linear regression with the help of the bill which we have already done. So let's open a new file here. So first we import the libraries. So I had a file called bill. Okay, it is bill, not bill underscore sample. So let's give it. So I got this file. Okay, I need to drop this. I got an extra column here. So we can also rename it. Okay, here we have got something which is wrong. So the first row I need to remove. Because the column is already deleted. Let's see the column. So the column is already deleted. This is the column. Okay, so now what we need to do is we want to do a linear relation, check the relationship between these two variables. So let's import seaborn. Of course, we can rename these columns. So we can see this is our scatter plot, which shows us our linear relationship. Now we can directly use sklearn. Now here we have to first find out, we have to separate this, that which one is x and which one is y. So df underscore x equal to df1 dot iloc this is for all rows, and the column here we are talking about only 0, and then df underscore y equal to df1 dot iloc, and we are talking about only 1. So now we are going to train the model. So let's see, model 1 equal to so this is, we are calling the constructor, then model 1 equal to model 1 dot fit. We are doing the training, that is df underscore x comma df underscore y. So this is, so our model is done. Now what we want to do is, if you write model 1, so this is our linear regression model is done. Now we want to predict, okay? So P is equal to model 1 dot predict, and predict what? Because this is a training model, we do not have the test data here. Okay, so let's predict. Or if you have a test data, you can give it here. And here P, we can find out the value of P. So this is the predicted value of P. And we might have an actual value of P which is there. That is the actual, because we already know this is the training data. So df underscore y will give you the actual data here. You can see this is 5, it is giving 4.15, 17 it has given 14.97, and 8.53 has been given, 11 has been marked as 8.53, 14 has been marked as 12.04. Not exact accurate, but it is quite similar. Okay, so now we want to check the prediction, what is the value of R square. Import R2 underscore score here, and here we can see model 1 and E. Here we have to give the value of y, df minus y, because we, for R2 square score, we have seen that R square is a ratio of the difference between the actual value of y and the predicted value of y. So it is giving me a score of 75% around. So with the help of, if linear regression is giving me a low score, we can go for multiple regression, because we have in the actual data we have a lot of features which we can mostly include, and we may improve the accuracy. So I hope you have understood this clearly, and that's all for today. Thank you so much.